Hello everybody, another boring shop video. Once again, what is that? 2:21 a.m. Wednesday, August 24th, 2011. 2 a.m., 2:30. What are we doing tonight? Or this morning? Well, we got a whole box of these parts right here. And these are the tubes that the pivot pins for each of our kits go in. So we cut them off on a bandsaw. And the pivot pin goes in it. The pivot pin has the chamfer right on the end. I'm going to put it right up here. You see that chamfer right there? That's to help you when you put it in. Okay? First, it's got to go through a tight bore that's already powder coated. Then it has to go through this tube, and then it has to go through the other bore on the other side. Okay? On the bottom of the hoist and on the top of the hoist. So the way we used to do it when we first started out, we'd use DOM tubing, drawn over mandrel. And you see how thick that is? Well, when you cut it off on a bandsaw, it leaves an inside lip on there. Okay, so you have to come back and cut that off. And it's very tight. Sometimes we had to bore these all the way through with the boring tool on the lathe to get the right size. Too big. This is similar to Schedule 80 pipe, but it's drawn over mandrel, and there's no weld on it. You can see that. So it's a little different than Schedule 80. It's heavy duty. There's no need for this for what we do. This is scrap, as far as I'm concerned. And I'll show you why. You can't get a 1-inch piece of stainless steel to go through it with a chamfer on it or anything. You have to bore it out. No way. So we use Schedule 40. This is one without a chamfer on it. It has a little clearance in there. So then you got plenty of room to go in there. But your problem comes in is if you're misaligned, if you're under the truck or if you're in the bed of the truck, whatever, however you want to put it in there, if you're misaligned by over 1/16 of an inch, you're going to need a hammer and it's not going to go in there. So we put a little chamfer on the pipe. So if you're misaligned by 1/8 of an inch, it will go in there without a hammer, by hand. Here's the difference. There's no chamfer on that one. It's getting ready to go into the lathe and get a chamfer put on it. It's just another step has to be done. Here's one with the chamfer on it. Okay, so it's chamfer against chamfer, and you know, it's a ramp right in there. It's like deer guts on a doorknob, nice and slick. It's going to go in the hole. So you don't waste a minute of your time putting it in there. Here's a whole bunch of them with chamfers on them. They're all different lengths because we have four different sizes of hoists. The problem comes in is when you're putting a big hoist in, and the tallest one here doesn't have a chamfer on it, you're getting ready to weld it onto a part, you know, weld it onto your cross member for a Ford, like I'm getting ready to do. It's already hot, sitting there waiting on me. I've got one done. I can go and weld that right now, and then do the other one later when I do the upper part of the hoist. But I decided to put a video out so you can see one extra step. It goes in the lathe. Gets the chamfer put on it. Just using a countersink tool. I'm going to swing around here. There it is. Goes in the chuck. You turn it. And then you come back with a file. You file it off on the end because it's going to raise some material. You file it off on the end. And then use a deburring tool, which is right here. We're going to file it off at almost 1200 RPM with a file, and then we're going to come in with a deburring tool on the interior to take the burrs off the inside, and that's going to be done at about 235 RPM. If you want me to run that, I can do that really quickly. I'm going to set the camera down. It's on a tripod. We're going to focus it on the chuck. Sorry for the wiggling. Here's the one that doesn't have a chamfer in it. Stick it in the chuck. Bring the tailstock up. Get it close like that. Back it off a little bit. Lock it down. Just a little touch of WD-40 on it. That'll smoke it. Here we go. See the smoke? She's getting hot and she's cutting. Unlock it. So the chamfer's in there. The problem now is it has a little ridge on the outside that'll cut somebody. So we're going to take that off of the file. We're going to crank it up to 1190. The file almost goes beyond the chuck. Stick it in there. That's all it takes is a little touch. Cut the lathe off. Put it in low gear. Deburn tool, it's just going to take anything off on the inside. If somebody sticks their finger in there, it won't cut them. That's all there is to it. Now when you put your pin in, I can do it from all the way out here. Hey, don't even need any grease. I'm going to grease it. Hope you enjoyed the show. See you next time.